object, domain, organization unit, tree, and forest. And this is, hello friends, welcome to ITK Funday, your own channel where we make IT interesting for everyone. And in this video, we will understand about one of the most requested topics from you all, which is Windows Active Directory. We will understand what is Active Directory, why we actually need it anyway, and what are the basic building blocks on top of which this very important component of networking works. And I'm pretty sure by the end of this video, you will have a basic understanding of what is Active Directory and how is exactly it is used. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. So friends, Google defines a directory as a book or website listing individuals or organizations in alphabetical or thematic sequence. What does that mean? That means that directory is a place wherein you put your resources and sequence it in a specific way. So in this case, you might be having a list of people organized in a way where you have their name, their email address, and their mobile number organized in a particular way. That is what is directory, the basic definition of directory. A real life example to understand Active Directory could be the menu card of any restaurant. Whenever you go to a restaurant, you get a dining menu, for example, and you have all the different cuisines which are available under different sections. So you could have appetizers, you could have starters, you could have your seafood, your Chinese, your Asian food. Then when you go to a specific section and go to a specific food item, you exactly understand what are the specific ingredients of that particular food item. So for a customer, it's very easy to see everything at one place and order something. So in a similar way, Active Directory lets enterprise companies organize all their resources very, very easily at one place. And these resources could be your servers, your employees, your files, and your locations, your directories, and your printers as well. So everything can be organized, managed, and administered very easily, and also with a lot of security. So now let's understand those five building blocks or components on top of which Active Directory logical architecture is built. And we'll understand it yet again with an easy example. So friends, these are the five core components of AD logical architecture: object, domain, OU, tree, and forest. Now we'll understand this with an example. Take for example this company which is named as Dummy Corp. And this Dummy Corp company has a domain which is duco.com. Now this duco.com is based on three different locations of the world: US, Europe, and Asia. Suppose an employee one joins the sales team of the US region of Duco company, and this particular employee joins, so this particular employee will be tagged as an object. Object is the most basic entity of an Active Directory, and this particular object will have its own attribute. Now for an employee, its employee ID, its address, email address, phone number, personal details, everything will form as attributes to this particular object. So this is the lowest entity. Okay, to organize different employees, suppose there are hundreds of employees joining under the sales department, you will create an OU. This is organizational unit. Now organizational unit is created to organize it. It's by no means, it's not a group in those terms, but it helps administrators organize. Suppose an administrator wants to assign sales file directory access to all the new joinees, all the 100 sales team, all the people joining in, all the 100 employees joining under sales team. So what they will do, they can give the access at OU level. Okay, and that can be propagated down to that particular group of employees which have joined in the sales department. So as we understand, that object is the most basic entity, and this particular object is organized under OUs, which are organization units, And then you have domains. So domains are nothing but the collection of all your objects. All your objects will fall under a certain domain. And now if you have watched my DNS video, domain name will be derived by the domain name server, and Active Directory server and domain name server goes hand in hand, and the functioning also is quite interrelated. So the moment Duco.com is organized and given to a dummy corp company, at the same time an Active Directory can be set up for this particular domain, which is Duco.com. Now this particular Duco.com is your root domain. Okay, this is your parent. This is your parent, and then you have these subdomains. And we are talking about Active Directory for now. Okay, don't confuse it with DNS. This is Active Directory, and we have the root domain, and then within that we have the US subdomain. Within the US subdomain, we have two different subdomains: one for sales, one for payroll. Under the sales subdomain, we have organization unit OU1, OU2, OU3. Under OU2, we have all the employees details, employees added as object. And similarly for OU3, we have all the servers: server 1, server 2, server 3. As I said, object could be anything. It could be employee, it could be printer, it could be server. So as you can see, it looks like a tree structure, and that's why Active Directory is a database of sorts, or database management system, which is hierarchical in nature, where you have parent-child relationship between your root domain, your subdomain, your organizational units, and your objects. So we have covered objects, we have covered domain, we have covered OU. What is a tree? So now tree is a combination of those objects and those domains which share the same namespace. Okay, so us.duco.com, eu.duco.com, and asia.duco.com, all this are part of a single tree because it is going to the same root. So this is your root of your tree, and these are your parts, your maybe you can say the branches of your root. Okay, so that's why it is called a tree. So now there could be, if we have to identify a tree structure here, it could be like this. So it could be like, if we tag this as domain A, this is domain B, and this could be domain C. So it is transitive in nature. So whatever is there, like A can have the trust with B, B can have the trust with C, and it is other way around also, which is transitive. So C can share the trust with B, and B can share the trust with A. So suppose if there is one server residing just at the lowest hierarchy as an object, it can go right up and access resources at Duco.com. Okay, because Duco.com is the root. And then maybe it could be that there could be a server in the Europe region. Now, if the proper permissions has been set up, this particular server can talk to this particular Europe server, which is maybe S5. Because this all forms under the same, same root. Now quickly understand what is a forest. As the name suggests, forest is combination of multiple trees, and that's why it helps us acquire new domains and merge it under a forest. So you can have multiple trees in the same way you can have multiple, companies merging under a forest. So suppose Dummy Corp is a company which buys a new company, which is dumbit.co.uk. And the domain for this is dumb.co.uk. These are some funny names so that you can remember the concepts. So it is a UK based company, no branches at all, based in UK, have, under this particular parent domain, it has HR and finance as the subdomain, and then respective objects under, respective OUs. So this is something which needs a merger. So Duco.com and dumbco.co.uk can be combined together under a single forest. So if I have to take these two and put it under a forest, now this forest will have some data coming from both the system. So a forest has a global catalog, which is kind of a collected information of all the domains which falls under a forest. So it could be all the details of dummycorp.com, duco.com, and also for dumbco.co.uk. So this particular forest, at this particular forest level,
everything will be visible and everything will be accessible. And you know, this particular global catalog might have some information stored at a global catalog level, but there could be some information which could be specific to an OU level also. It all depends how you design your Active Directory and how you want this Active Directory to work. So based on that, you can put things at the forest level, global catalog level, and then it could be accessible across across all the different trees within one particular forest. So that's those are five components: object, domain, organization unit, tree, and forest. And this is how we define our whole logical architecture. Again, I will iterate that everything which we see in Active Directory is very closely related to a domain name server, because there is another very key concept which we will understand now when we go to the physical architecture of Active Directory, and that is a domain controller and the physical architecture, how exactly it works and how DNS plays a role in that. So now let's quickly understand the physical architecture of Active Directory. So friends, now as we have understood the logical architecture, now quickly touch base upon some aspects of the physical architecture. It would not be in depth, but it would give you some understanding of how a physical architecture looks like. So logical architecture is the way it is it is designed to be managed at a logical layer, but underneath that there is a physical layer where actual components are deployed. So take for example this same structure under a forest, because now we have merged two companies. So D1 and D2 you can consider as two different domains coming under a single forest. So every domain is associated with a domain controller. So whenever you are trying to install, suppose you take a Windows 2016 server and you want to set up a domain, the very first thing which you have to do is you have to install the domain controller on that particular server, so that it can recognize, it can work as an Active Directory. Because under a domain controller you have three key components, which is the data store, the schema, and the actual DB. So your data store is kind of your front-end services like AD, Kerberos, LDAP, which does the fronting. So these are the services which can be considered as APIs, and these APIs exposes the schema details and the DB details to the end user. So suppose if you are logging to your laptop, what you do, you enter your domain and your employee ID, right? And then you hit enter to log into the network. What happens? It first goes to the DNS server, and then the DNS server, understanding the nearest domain controller in your area, in your network, it passes on that detail to that particular domain controller. That domain controller will accept the request and understand, so this request has come from employee 123. Let me check if employee 123 is there in my domain controller database or not. And it will check that through this front-end data store service, which has been called, suppose if you are using Active Directory service, LDAP, a lightweight Active Directory service, any service or API, through that, it will go to the database, and it will also go to the schema, because the schema stores the metadata information about object. So an employee, so what kind of structure that particular employee object will have, will be stored in the schema, and DB will have the actual data. So to hide these from the front-end users, the data store comes into picture, and this whole thing is encapsulated under a domain controller. Now you can have multiple domain controllers to manage a single domain. It all depends on how you design. And it could also happen that suppose if employee is not present in this particular domain controller, it could be that it might search other domain controllers also, because understand that all this data is replicated seamlessly across different domain controllers, because it should not happen that I am in one particular domain and then there is no entity of mine there in domain 2, because ultimately I am a part of this overall forest, right? So all the domain controllers need to be in sync and replicating the data frequently, so that there is that that synergy is maintained and that unanimity is maintained in terms of what data is stored under specific domain controllers. So I hope you now know a bit more about Active Directory, and next time you know anything about Windows AD or you come to work with Windows AD, you will have some more information than what you had previously. So friends, I hope you liked this video and you learned something new about Active Directory. If you did, please hit the like button so that YouTube knows that there is something useful going on this channel. Please hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you exactly know when I upload my next video. Also, let me know your beautiful comments, your good comments, your bad comments. Everything is welcome because it helps me improve my content. So until next time, please keep learning, guys. Keep growing. And yes, keep hustling. Bye for now.